From a time a million years before our history began, the great oceans of this planet have cast a spell over humankind. The first time we stood at the edge of the sea and let our imagination wander beyond that endless horizon, the oceans became for us the symbol of everything that was mysterious in this universe, everything that was powerful, everything that was beyond human ability to master. Every voyage is a voyage of discovery, and taken to the sea is always a passage into the unknown. Every voyage begins with a dream, and every landfall, great or small, is the realization of a dream. Those voyages we record in history are the discoveries of new worlds, of unknown continents, of treasures beyond imagination. But there have been thousands of others, never recorded at all, in which the great discovery was an inner discovery, the discovery of the sailor's true nature, the discovery of the self. In all of history, more people have been in space than have sailed around the world alone in the ultimate test of seamanship and courage. One person, one boat, around the world alone. For most of human history, the idea that a single sailor, alone or on a vessel with no crew, could circle the entire world under sail was unthinkable. When Joshua Slocum first did it in the last century, a new breed of sailors was born, the single-handed circumnavigators. But where Slocum's vessel was made of wood, and he had only a simple sextant for navigation, the modern single-hander has access to a stunning array of high-tech materials and techniques. Most have recognized the value technology can bring them in safety and performance. But the sailors remain cautious, because all seafarers know that no matter how much the technology of sailing changes, the sea is the same as it has been for millions of years. The world of wind and water, a world in which no 2 seconds are the same. A world that can realize dreams and can destroy them in fractions of a second. Every 4 years, an international fleet of single-handed sailors gathers for the longest, hardest yacht race in the world. The BOC Challenge is the longest race on Earth for an individual in any sport, 27,000 miles around the world.
The days leading up to the race, there's a lot of hectic activity in getting the boat ready and getting that boat to the start line. And normally, sort of, those last few days, I try and not think about the race. I try and concentrate on the jobs on hand.
Before the race begins, a skipper has the help of a shore crew, whether professionals or a group of friends. But the single-handed sailor at sea has only himself to rely on. In an emergency, the nearest help may be thousands of miles away. Even to contemplate this solitary danger, one needs courage, vision, and above all, painstaking preparation.
The most difficult part in solo sailing is that every minute you have to decide something. And it's not very easy because you are alone to decide.